Wednesday, September 2nd, the year of our Lord, 2015. How are all y'all doing out there? I'm doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's Yeehaw! Western Wednesday. It's Happy Hump Day! Hump Day! Damn right! Two more days to you, vegan ain't fatty, y'all. That's right. And it's all about the truth. Paul Pierce. A Celtic for life. I know he's not on the Celtics anymore, but I love this guy. Always have, always will. Today's unofficial sponsor of our show. And I love them as well. Great hanging out over at Lucy's Big Burgers. Right down here in good old Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. Pretty much the same damn state. That's right. Great to see our dear friends Rick and his wonderful, gorgeous, better half, Amy Graven. Rick and Amy Graven, the owners of Lucy's Burgers. Best burger joint by far in all of good old Abilene. Hell, one of the best in all the world, y'all. Just saying. And, wow, I'm still full. And this was during lunch, hanging out with my good friend, my buddy, Matt Pugh. A great leader of men, women, and it's that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. That's right. And he loved you. He loved you guys over at Lucy's Burgers. I knew you would, Matt. Robert, Amy, you two are a blessing to call friends. And folks, look at that food, will you? That's the Texas burner right there, y'all. With Robert's homemade habanero barbecue sauce. Made from scratch. Half-pound patties. Fresh-cut fries. Homemade ice cream. Oh, by the way, we're going back to Lucy's on Friday because Amy said that she will make sure that my love goddess gets her banana pudding ice cream made from scratch. Ha! No Bluebell around here? No problem. We've got Robert and Amy Graven and Lucy's Burgers. And we're always happy. And then, of course, it's time to bring out today's beer of the day. It is football season, folks. So it wouldn't be me if I didn't bring out the proper chiller beer box. See, chiller beer, very dear friends of mine, Jack and Cindy Skinner, met them last year at the Taylor County Fair. That's right, and that's coming down here next week to good old Abilene. That's right, chiller beer box. Look for them. We got to get them more likes. Chillerbeer.com. That's C-H-I-L-L-A-B-E-E-R.com. Check them out on the old Facebook. Just type in chiller beer box or chiller beer. And comes with an ice pack. Obviously, whatever favorite team you got. In my case, obviously, Red Sox, Patriots, Celtics, and Bruins. It's got a beer opening apparatus right there for you in case you forget your own. And, of course, it carries six beers very comfortably. Keeps them cold with a nice cold ice pack. Awesome stuff. Highly recommended. And, hey, so you're going to get a six-pack where? Over at Philo Liquors. Duh! That's right. And I got a few good friends of mine that made it over to Philo Liquors today. And they got this. Not your father's root beer. Maybe it's your mother's? I don't know. Philo Liquors. Best place of them all to get good quality adult beverages. If you don't believe me, ask my good friend Dennis Beach, who had one of these. My good friend Big Al Hammonds. He had himself some of this. My man Carl Holland, badass age ranger, didn't star because danger is no stranger to an age ranger. Carl Holland, you love this stuff too. You guys, the three of you, incredible folks, Dennis, Big Al, Carl, yep, you took the Love Doc's advice and said, yep, got to get my carcass along with the rest of me over to Philo Liquors. And they hooked you up as I told you they would. That's what we do. Good people, helping good people to reach out to good other people and we all win. Proper opening apparatus, proper technique, here we go, y'all. Oh, what a good pop. It's like pulling your head out of your boot. No, I'm just saying. And look at that. The official beer and song of the day. Wicked awesome beer consumption apparatus. You don't see it very well yet. You will when it gets dark. 45 degree angle right in the beer consumption apparatus. Right on the keyboard. Because I'm sad damn good. Haven't spilled drop yet. Never have. Never will. Oh, yes. Look at that. Beer and song of the day. Wicked awesome. My likeness on the front of the glass. And on the back, of course, represented by Philo Liquors. Because teamwork makes the dream work, folks. Cheers to beers, all y'all. Pro said Germany compies the same in Japan. I gotta admit, I'm tired. So you know what? A little bit of root beer. Adult root beer. That's a good way to wake you up. Just saying. The big solid A plus all the way brew with nutmeg in it. Oh my goodness. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. All right. We do have some birthday shout-outs to give, and I got three of them to give. And there's Princess Delilah. Look at her. Get your butt in here, Princess Delilah.
Hi.
You know where we went today, right? Well, Daddy did and Mr. Matt. We went to...
Hang on, let me slap you with it.
Princess Delilah's not happy that I went to Lucy's without her. But what's going to happen on Friday?
We're going to go to Lucy's.
We're going to see Mr. Robert.
Yeah.
And Miss Amy. Remember them?
Yes. I just forgot their names.
Ah. We absolutely love them, don't we?
Yeah.
Yup.
So, hey, don't bend that. I need that for future shows. Goober butt. Bad news. Red Sox got lost to the Yankees. I know. It's horrible. Bad year this year. But you know what? It's all right.
You know what? Yankees.
That's how my daughter feels about them.
I just don't want to say it.
Well, you're not going to say it. You're not an adult. But I'll drink to that.
Come here, Patches. Come here, Patches. Come here. Ugh. Hey, Patches, don't lift up my dress.
Patches. Such a loving dog. Not a smart dog. All right. Well, we do have three shout-outs to give, three birthdays. And one of them is a very dear friend of ours and a big-time fan of Beer and Song of the Day. And my good friend, Renee Phillips, an incredible Christian friend, an incredible mommy, an incredible wife, an incredible walking positive motivation. Big time Wicked Hardcore Tennessee Volunteers fan. My dear friend, Renee Phillips, happy birthday to you. How are you? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. I know you're doing well. And I guarantee this show's going to be méchant génial, French for wicked awesome. You know what I'm saying, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Kevin, thank you guys for love. My name is nothing I do now on Bears Long Day every single day of the week. Beanie. Aye. So there you go. The show's going to be wicked pisser. That's right. Renee, happy birthday. I know Jason's spoiling you rotten. He's such an awesome guy and a hardworking man. A great daddy, a great friend, great husband from what I gather. I don't know. I've never been married to him. Never been married to you. And not going to happen because I'm married to the greatest woman in the world. No offense, Renee, but it's true. But Renee, much love to you from the Love Doctor. Happy birthday. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and bears. Renee's a former multiple fan of the week winner, I might add. And don't worry, Renee. More's coming. Next on the list, my good friend, Kyle Harper. A badass spot-chasing son of a gun that I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as West Louisiana, pretty much the same damn state. That's right. Kyle, brother, you're moving down to good old Houston. Got yourself a great job down there. We're going to miss you around this here place and on the job site. An awesome guy, incredible work ethic. But, brother, you're going to go even higher. You're going to definitely do well. I have faith in you. You're a smart guy. You're a walking brain of a man. Kyle Harper, happy birthday. Hope you all have an awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Oh. Final birthday today goes to my good friend, Dan Roberts. Dan the Man Roberts. Badass mafioso I know on the old Mafia Wars. Longtime friend on the old Facebook. Dan, that's right. We play Mafia Wars together. We help each other out. We get stronger by giving each other gifts so that we can crush the opposition. It's a lot of fun, but nobody gets hurt for real. Dan Roberts, happy birthday to you, my friend. And I hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Big gulps. I'm parched. This does 5.9% alcohol by volume. Definitely above average in strength. And it's out of good old La Crosse, Wisconsin. Or as they could say it up there, Wisconsin. Small town brewery, La Crosse. Like the sport, but separate. La and then Crosse. La Crosse, Wisconsin. Beer with natural vanilla extract, other natural and artificial flavors, and caramel color. Tastes like nutmeg in there, but you can definitely notice the vanilla too. Awesome. I love it. All right, y'all. Squeeze me. That's the lowest amount of birthdays I've had in a single day in a long, long time. So, y'all know what time it is, right? Time to give it up for our trivia question. And this trivia question was awesome. What legendary country singer sang the very popular song, "She Thinks My Tractor's Sexy"? Great song. Our good friends, Lucky Windsor Dimmitt, an incredible dog, incredible duo of dogs in exotic Japan. You abso-freaking-smurf-alutely nailed it. You said Kenny Chesney. Actually, it went, something like that. Well, you absolutely nailed it. Wicked awesome job. And a big, I've got to salute to you. Oh, hell yeah! There you go, Lucky Windsor Dimmitt. Arrgh. Hopefully your owners feed you a milk bone or two, you know? You earned it. Like Smith Barney, you made it the old-fashioned way. You earned it. Cheers and beers. All right, y'all. Without telling, we got some additional shout-outs I gotta give right here, right now. Gotta give it up to my good friend Jason Phillips, of course, the wonderful, awesome husband of one Renee Phillips, and their two incredible daughters, Krista Phillips and Kat Raina. Krista, Kat, Jason, or as Renee called you, Jace. I feel like I shouldn't call you Jace because only she can do that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's a guy thing. You can't call each other the cute names, you know? You can't call me babe. Nobody calls me babe except for my love goddess, all right? But anyway, to the Phillips family, from the love doctor to all y'all, I give you the love doctor salute. I know you're spoiling your awesome Renee Phillips incredibly well, and she is having a good day today. No question about it. So to the Phillips family, a big hearty cheers and beers. To my good friends, Aaliyah Trinidad and Willie Holt, you two incredible Mafia Wars players. Aaliyah, I haven't given you a shout out in a while. It's great to see you back on the Facebook. I hadn't seen you in a while. Absolutely gorgeous. Total sweetheart. Very dear friend of mine. Living in good old California, the land of fruits, and that's otherwise known as Southern Oregon. Of course, Willie Holt. He's one fan of the week more than anybody else in the history of Beer and Song of the Day. Willie Holt. Aaliyah Trinidad, the two of you are absolutely wicked awesome. I want to give you two a shout out. Why? Because I can. Major problem with Not Your Father's Root Beer. Goes down too fast. But that's all right, y'all. I got backups. Never had this here before. I love Goose Island Brewing Company. What is it? Well, it's brewed in Chicago, Illinois, Baldwinsville, New York, and Fort Collins, Colorado. So I don't know which of the three it's brewed at. There's three different breweries that Goose Island represents. They're all over the country now. Goose Island Autumn Ale. I've never had it. I'm excited. I love those fall beers. When I pick it up? Gee, imagine that. File of liquors, y'all. This stuff is brewed spicy hop flavors and dry finish. Airy pine aromas. Didn't know I was going to drink a tree. We'll see how it goes. 6.7% alcohol by volume. Wow. Definitely above average of strength. Proper building apparatus, proper technique. Here we go, y'all. Goose Island. And right into the proper beer and song of the day, Wicked Awesome Beer Consumption Apparatus. 45 grand right in the beer consumption apparatus, right over the keyboard, because I'm sad damn good. Haven't supposed to drop yet. Never will. Whoa. Saved it. Because spilling a beer is a crime. It's a felony. Alcohol abuse is a felony. Cheers and beers to all y'all. Pro Sin, Germany, Kapai, and Sin, Japan. Hoppy, but not too hoppy. Piney, but not too piney. I like this beer. Got a little bite to it. It's a good beer. I give it a B. B. Good. Good beer. All right, y'all. So there you go. Whew. And I got full belly from my Texas burner over Lucy's Burgers. I'm stuffed like a Thanksgiving turkey. All right, some quick additional shout-outs. My man, Bill Boucher. Bill, two more days, brother. Yup. Squeeze me. And I get to see you and your awesome son, Ben. They're coming down here from Northern Texas, a.k.a. Oklahoma. And, hiccups now. Oh, boy. Bill and Ben, we're going to hang out. We're going to party like it's 1969 minus the acid. Can't wait to see the two of you. Awesome times. Bill, I haven't seen you in 15 years. Ben, I haven't seen you before. Last time I saw you, you weren't even born yet. Wow. All right. Bill, Ben, cheers and beers. Jeff Carter, Lashelle Bullock, two incredible leaders of men, women, and it's. Hanging out with you two today was enlightening. It was epic. It was awesome. Jeff Carter, dude. Oh, hadn't seen you in a while. Always a pleasure chatting with you, man. And I had to give you a shout out on Beer and Song of the Day. Lashelle Bullock, I know you love both kinds of music, country and western. Hey, that's what they said in the Blues Brothers. I love all kinds of music. I do. But Lashelle, Jeff, the two of you reek of exquisite, wicked awesomeness. So I'll give you a shout out And I say, I'll be hearty, cheers and beers, hope y'all enjoy the show. And finally, to an incredible lady, an incredible friend, my good friend, Melodie Hassel. Ah, such a sweetheart of a lady. Big fan of Beer and Song of the Day, and I'm a big fan of you. We need more people like you in the world, no doubt about it. Be fruitful and multiply. Have a litter of kids, will you? Melodie, absolutely beautiful, positive attitude all the time. We need more. There's no doubt about it. Ay, ay, ay. But Melodie, I want to give you a shout out. Because the Love Doctor loves awesome fans like you. Apps are freaking smurfalutely. So cheers and beers to you, my friend. Mmm. With that said, it's time for our vehicle of the day. That's not a vehicle of the day, but that's a Tom Brady upper deck graded rookie card. I bought it for $2 in Guam when he was a nobody before he even played a game in the NFL. That card's worth a few hundred bucks now. All right. So, my good friend Jason Phillips, Renee said she wanted a real vehicle today on Baron Song of the Day. So, how about your 1995 Chevy Camaro? Look at that beautiful automobile. Sleek, fast, beautiful. Great color, too. Looks like a kind of a, almost a turquoise. Light bluish green. That's a pretty car. Beautiful automobile for a super stud muffin like you, Jason. Hell yeah. I don't know if you have that car anymore. I hope you do, but man, what a mighty fine automobile that is. That's wicked fast for a wicked cool guy. 1995 Chevy Camaro. Jason Phillips. Chevy Camaro. Now it's time for our instrument of the day, y'all. And how about yeehaw country singer Kenny Chesney? Oh, I know, ladies and you men to love him, men. He's a super stud muffin. I get it. Phenomenal country singer. Just a phenomenal guy. And there's his guitar. This guy's still making incredible music. He's 47 years old. I know he's 47 and a gift sent from heaven. I get that. Of course, I think all men are ugly, disgusting, and repulsive, but that's me. Because I love beautiful women. I do. That's why I'm married to one. Married to the most beautiful woman in the world. I am truly blessed, and I'm the luckiest man in the world. All right, y'all. So how about today's pen of the day? She's simply known as Miss Turtle Phillips. Ah, pet turtle. It's our first ever pet turtle on Baron Song Day. Jason and Renee and Krista and Kat's pet turtle, Miss Turtle Phillips. Ah, ain't she a cutie? She sure is. Aquatic pet of the day. That's our first aquatic pet of the day, I do believe. May have to do that more often. Just saying. Let's drink to that. All right, y'all. It is time for our hug of the day on Beer and Song Day. And you know, we mentioned the song already. Folks, per request of my good friend Renee Phillips, the birthday girl, happy birthday indeed, my friend. Because she thinks my track is sexy. Kenny Chesney, y'all. She thinks my tractor's sexy. Listen to the song. Yeah. A lot of celebrity birthday things. Tons of them. Fields in the hot summer sun. Over by the gate, Lordy. Yeehaw. Comes with a basket full of chicken and a big cold jug of sweet tea. Keanu Reeves, 51 years old today. Salma Hayek, 49, and Wicked Fine. Open up a throttle and start her a little dust. Just look at her face. Mark Harmon. My wife loves that man. Phenomenal actor, NCIS. My lovely artist thinks I'm sexy. I think she's got two glass eyes, but hey, it's all good. I ain't complaining. Chugging along? Hell, I'll be chugging along, and all y'all should too, as long as you're not driving. She's even kind of crazy about my farmer's tan. She's the only one who really Madeline Bailey, pop singer, 23, cutie. Cat Williams. Now, Cat Williams, African-American comedian. A lot of people love him. I think he's okay. I think he's pretty good. I think he's overrated. He can't hold a candle to George Carlin, Richard Pryor, Red Fox, Eddie Murphy, or Rodney King. But Cat Williams is pretty doggone good, y'all. He's 42 years old today. I got a very good friend of mine that's 42 years old today. How about that? They're born the exact same month, day, and year as the legendary comedian Cat Williams. But they're better and more talented. A lot of legends born this day, 1948. How about Pittsburgh Steelers quarterback Terry Bradshaw? He's 67 years old today. As is Nate Tiny Archibald, number one, Boston Celtics. Love that guy, point guard. Tiny Archibald, Nate Tiny Archibald, 67 today. Krista McCullough. Sadly, the only teacher that's ever gone into space. We know what happened to the Space Shuttle Challenger, January 28, 1986. The program teachers in space, Krista McCullough, teacher from New Hampshire, and they blew up a minute and 28 seconds into the atmosphere, or something like that, after liftoff, something like that. Krista McCullough, born in 1948, I already mentioned. Killed at the much too young age of 37, January 28, 1986. Harvey Levin, entrepreneur, lawyer, founder of TMZ. But did you know he was a lawyer for over 20 years? And he was also a, on the team for writing team or whatever, and somewhere for the People's Court, you know, Wapner. Lennox Lewis, legendary boxer, British boxer, probably the most famous British boxer of all time. 50 years old, a milestone birthday to him. How about that? Shayla Worley. Oh, yeah, Shayla Worley, gymnast, cutie, 25, perfect age. Lamar Johnson, former Major League ball player. I remember him. 9 seasons in the Major Leagues. Never a great career, but he did something really cool in 1977, y'all. Listen to this. He sang the national anthem before a game in 1977 with his team, the Chicago White Sox. That game, hit 2 home runs in the game. Talk about making a huge impact. Lamar Johnson. Excuse me, senior citizen. And then finally, Adolph Rupp. From head coach of Northern Tennessee, a.k.a. Kentucky basketball team. Probably one of the greatest coaches in college basketball history. Born in the state in 1901, passed away in 1977. 876 lifetime wins, only 190 losses. Incredible winning percentage. Coached for 4 different decades. University of Kentucky, yo. That's right. So there you go, your final Hunk of the Day pictures. There you go, Renee Phillips. Ask and you shall receive. How about that, y'all? Mm-hmm. Kenny Chesney, topless. Why is it that men can go topless but women can't? I don't know. I think it's wrong. I believe in equal rights, y'all. Just saying. Men and women should both be able to go topless freely and without any complaints. Why? I'm all about equality, y'all. Just saying. All right, so there's your... celebrity birthdays on Baron's song. Oh, we do have a celebrity wedding anniversary. I just ran across this. They were married 13 years today. Freddie Prinze Jr., Sarah Michelle Gellar. Now, folks, I'll tell you what. Famous Hollywood marriages generally don't work, but sometimes they do. It's rare, but they do. And I hope to God Freddie Prinze Jr., Sarah Michelle Gellar will keep it going strong forever. You know, Freddie Prinze Jr. should be slapped senseless if he cheated on Sarah Michelle Gellar. And I know you ladies and you men that love the men also say Sarah Michelle Gellar should be slapped silly if she cheats on Freddie Prinze Jr. I get that. Now look at that. Renee, that's for you. He's wearing a Tennessee volunteer shirt. And there's your Tennessee dog. Aw, so cute. Your mascot. College football this weekend. Get your chili beer box. All right, let's drink. All right, folks, very important. Renee, this one goes out to you and your dad. Renee Phillips has finally stepped up. I told her a long time ago, I said, Renee, you were dropped dead ago. I just told her, sweetheart, 283 Jolie, you are very pretty. Ageless wonder you are. Positive attitude, that will do it. Well, her awesomeness, and there's her awesome man, Jason. Jason and Renee, aren't they a gorgeous couple? You doggone right they are. Renee has a song that goes out to her father. Her father is suffering from Alzheimer's, a sad and incurable, crippling disease that is just rotten and cruel. Her dad's 69 years old, and he's a fantastic man. And Renee, this is a fantastic song from you to your fantastic father. While he still knows who I am. Great song. I don't want to interrupt you. I want all y'all to hear the lyrics. So if the show goes over 30 minutes, you'll understand. As Renee Phillips is finally our real baby today on Baron Song Day. Yeah!
Like him, I'm a baseball fan.
Football fan, too.
I'm going back.
He's a 49ers fan. She's a Tennessee Titans fan, of course, y'all.
While he's still.
Yeah, he's tall, I know.
Who I am.
Great song. Great couple right here, folks.
Mama says he came.
Hey, yo, Jason, we're representing my beloved Boston Red Sox.
Daddy thinks that he still came.
Renee, you're wicked awesome.
I'm going back to see him while he still knows.
Remember that, y'all.
Who I am.
Always remember that. Never get a second chance. Every day, you tell your loved ones you love them. Every day. You never know.
Instead of just shaking hands, gonna tell him that I love him while he still knows.
It was Mustache Madness Month right there.
Who I am.
Yeah, that's right, Jason.
I only knew him.
This incredible couple's now been married for over 19 years. Aw, they were so cute then. They're so cute now. Represent Tennessee, y'all.
Still,
she sure loves her volunteers.
Who I am. This time I'm gonna kiss her.
Hell, I'll drink Tennessee volunteer. Why not? I'm all right with them. Unless I'm playing my Patriots. Then they go. Niner time. She represents her husband's team a little bit as well. San Francisco 49ers. Don't know how good they're going to be this year, but that's all right, though. Seems like a thing. You got to represent. That's what true fans do, y'all. Damn, isn't she beautiful? Hot diggity dog, damn right she is. Aww. Look at that. They were young then. Jason, Renee, Krista, and Kat.
I know
the Fab Four of exquisite, wicked awesomeness. I love all y'all. I do.
We're slowing down.
That's
while
right.
We can.
Incredible.
I'm going home.
That is an incredible babe of the day. A real babe of the day. A very dear friend. Drop dead gorgeous. Total sweetheart. Awesome stuff. Hey, let's talk about this day in history real quick. 2 years ago, swimmer Diana Nyad makes history becoming the first person to swim from Cuba to Florida without a shark cage. I call that nook and fence myself. That's just dumb. Crazy. On this day in 1987, Phillips introduces the CD video. Hey, you know what that's known as today? DVD. Honestly, 1978. Speaking of couples that have been married a while, Gloria Fajardo, 21 years old, married Emilio Estefan, who was 25 years old, of the Miami Sound Machine. Well, get this, y'all. Gloria Estefan and her husband Emilio have been married for 37 years today. A famous marriage that worked, that deserves. She is a miss. I say 1971, Chris Everett and Jimmy Connors win their first U.S. Open tennis matches. Cool. I say 1965, day Keanu Reeves was born, Norman Manley scores two consecutive holes in one. Wow, at Del Valle, California. I don't think it was miniature golf course either. I say 1963, CBS and NBC expand coverage network news from 15 to 30 minutes. On this day in 1960, Tamara and Arina Press of the Soviet Union become the first ever sisters to win Olympic gold. On this day in 1954, my father remembers it well. Right after Hurricane Carol, you had Hurricane Edna battered New England, the Northeast U.S., killing 20 people, unfortunately. Wow, just brutal in 1954 for the Northeast. On this day in 1945, though, something that's wicked awesome, unless you're Japan or France. Ho Chi Minh declared Vietnam independence for France 70 years ago today. Excuse me. And VJ Day, Victory in Japan Day, formal surrender of Japan aboard the USS Missouri, or as they call it up there, Missouri. World War II, officially over. They had called VJ Day even before then, but the official formal surrender. On day 1944, during World War II, George Bush, the first George Bush, ejected from a burning airplane. Wow, he's only 20 years old. Man. Some people are mean. I just read some people's minds. How dare you? RJ 1941, Academy Copyrights Oscar Statuette. Hey, the Oscar for the Academy Awards. RJ 1940, did you know this there, Renee Phillips? Great Smoky Mountains National Park is dedicated. Gorgeous place in good old Tennessee, otherwise known as Southern Kentucky. RJ 1937, U.S. Housing Authority created by National Housing Act. On this day, 1930, first non-stop airplane flight from Europe to the United States took 37 hours. Wow. On this day, 1901, Vice President Teddy Roosevelt advises. No. Oh, that's right. He won. He became president 2 weeks later. He said this. He said, "Speak softly and carry a big stick." 4 days later, of course, William McKinley, the president, was shot. 8 days later after that, September 14, he passed away. It was assassinated. Leon Czolgosz. Of course, Teddy Roosevelt took over as president. Youngest president to serve ever. Only 42 years old at the time. Even younger than JFK. Oz in 1898, the machine gun first used in battle. Yeah! Must have been the Spanish-American War. Oz in 1865, Union General William T. Sherman captures Atlanta. Atlanta, Georgia. Ah, William T. Sherman's March to the Sea, as they called it. On this day in 1789, U.S. Treasury Department established by Congress. And finally, on this day in 1666, the Great Fire in London, jolly old England, sadly destroyed 13,000 houses. Very famous fire. I say only 8 people were killed. Fire like that could have been a lot worse. But you know what, y'all? It's time to drink Slam at Home. Empty as the brain cells of an average New York Jets fan. Folks, y'all know what time it is, right? Damn right, remember that to be. First time I'm going to feed us the head out. So everybody take care. We'll get an awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive, my spirit drink. All you might kill yourself or somebody else. And drinking and driving is dumber than being a Yankees fan. Or what's dumber than that is being a fan of Justine. Yeah, I'm so annoying that the United States and Canada hate me. Yeah, along with the rest of the world because you're such a dweeb. Beaver. What's dumber than that towards men sleeping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people to watch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports fans or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church or ISIS? Things like that are just plain stupid. And definitely deserve a big fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see all y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Y'all come back now. You hear?